Regions are a Visual Studio thing, so if your code editor doesn't offer them, feel free to skip this video, as they are not needed for our dialogue system. I'm simply going to create a few regions to make the code a little bit more organized and readable. It just makes it easy for us to navigate through our code, as we can easily hide the region of our code. We'll start with the GraphView script, and the first region we are going to add is for the overrided methods. So at the top of our getCompatibleParts method, we type in region and name it overrided methods. And then at the bottom, we finish it off with endRegion. We are now able to hide our overrided methods. We'll be creating another region for our manipulator, so type in region manipulators on top of our addManipulators method, and hand it under our getGroupContextualMenu method. Next, we'll be creating a region above our createGroup method, and I'll name it elementsCreation, and hand it under the createNode method. As the final region, we'll add it above the addGridBackground method, to which I'll name it elementsAddition, and hand it under the addStyles method. We'll be doing the same for our editor window, so let's head to the editor window script, and we are going to create an elementsAddition region on top of our addGraphView method, and hand it under the addStyles method. And that's pretty much it for now. I'll be updating the regions throughout the rest of the tutorial as I see fit, so feel free to add them in as well if you want to. There might be something like these or even plugins that allow you to do the same in other code editors, but I'll leave that for you to search.